following show feature stunts performed either by professionals or under the supervision of professionals. Accordingly, DFV and the producers must insist that these bits have been previously released on either Netflix, Paramount Plus, YouTube, Instagram, TikTok, etc.
My boy Sherb hooked me up with some camera guys that came out. Beautiful fellas, man. One of the boys had beautiful eyes. One of them had beautiful hair. He had the falls coming off the back.
It takes balls to drop the balls. But I'll tell you this, man, when you show up, no shot, boo boo,
you know there might be a bird living in.
I know that. Jump out of the soul, jump out of the soul. Head of the town, flow, yeah. Head of the same, it's on me. Fell asleep on the yard. My name's in a while. Cut a billy, I taste it. I need him against the rock. You be tripping, you be smoking the crack. You be smoking a rock. Eat it, I've been shipping it up for months. I'm shipping it all. Shut that name on that time. Got a better figure than I. I done leveled up. I put points in my ring. I done leveled up. I'm in the store. I'm in Celine. Your bitch be choosing behind your back. She said she wanted me. 365 bands in a year. To the 665 bands, I'm out of here. Busted a nut on her face and sun got in her hair. Meet the ace with the perk.
Yep. And I hope I'm not. I don't mean to offend anybody. If you are offended, just, you know, kill yourself. But like, I'm just kidding.
Woo, baby doll. That was, it comes right back. I mean, 85 plus days out, whatever it's been. Half full or whatever the hell it was, didn't feel bad. Everybody's like, ugh, half full, that's gonna be horrible. It was fine. And I think when you're coming right back in, half full is a good thing. I wanna slide in. I don't wanna go back to the garden. Not that I was doing the garden. But you know what I mean. So it's great. I realized why I do this. I can't believe I get to do this. That's the one perk of a pandemic, if I can say so, is taking, I would never have taken that much time off. I was forced to take time off, as we all are. And it makes you appreciate, I do this every weekend. It became like autopilot. And then to go back up there after 80 days and be like, oh my God, this is so amazing what I'm doing. I wrote this and they're laughing and it's flowing and the lights and the crowd and beautiful thing. I'm getting sappy and queefy up here, but it's good to be back. That was great. And now I can't take another break. I gotta keep going. Here we are in the hotel room. A lot of semen, some lotion somewhere, best deodorant. Stand behind it. Hey, Corona. Now some businesses are opening with curbside pickup. Prostitutes said, hey, we've been doing that the whole time. All right, we'll try it. We'll give it a whirl. So hopefully there's a crowd tonight. And yeah, we'll yuck it up and probably offend somebody. But
it's sold out.
Is it? What? Sold out? I didn't know that. Oh my God.
Are you kidding? Come on, man! Come on! Dude,
that was so fucking...
Oh my God, that would have made...
I would have left. Here we are, Austin, Texas. One of my first theater gigs ever. At the Paramount. Sold out, 25% capacity. Not bragging. Hey, we're bananas. That was a whole other show. The first show, I died. Great town. I'm gonna go run over next door.
Gonna go.
Hey, great brain. Nice shoulders. Good hair. Hey, nice gun.
Oh, thank you.
New York, they brought it in. Good for them.
what you just saw, like, that's Solette right now. It's
pretty
like,
cool.
So
that's our
like,
key. We got a big GoFundMe, and we got her that in New York. And then she brought it here. Pretty cool. Good for her. We're going to go see Rebecca, old pal from New York. Started her own club in Austin. Good for her. She's moving up in the world. Let's give it a whirl.
Let's go. You guys gonna come back and see it?
Yes, come on.
We don't wear masks anymore. Masks are illegal.
Oh,
wow, this place is huge.
It's so good to see you.
You too.
How's it going?
Great. Sorry, I'm a little hungover.
Nice.
Yeah, this is Rebecca. She runs the joint.
Hi, nice to meet you.
Old pal from New York. Started the whole thing, and now she's here. Wow, this is unreal.
This is just the front. You want to see the back?
Yeah.
These are the real pinball machines from New York, too.
Whoa, and you got the marquee.
Yep.
Love it. Wow.
This is not ready yet. This is just so
good. Whoa, this is perfect.
Let me walk you through. I'll show you.
Please, give us a tour.
White balance.
Oh, hell. That's great. Low ceiling, nice and wide. Woo-wee, this is going to be a doozy.
Okay. How am I ever gonna live up to that? Plus, I never saw this bitch in a fucking tree.
Sure.
This has been fun.
I like. Don't you think I look like a beer?
Yeah.
Like, apply an abstract lens. Like, I think, like, if a beer turned into a human being, it would look like this. This is, like, you know. Like if there was another character in the Beauty and the Beast who was like a pint of IPA, you know what I mean? Like hanging out with the candlestick and the little teacup with the chipped tooth. And then when the curse got lifted, they all turned back into people like, Your Highness, it's me, Sudsy!
I saw a whole thing. Oh. She fall back. I just fucked on this little bitch, she fall back to ya. I just walked outside, why is it a cheater? Slick, diamonds on my mirror. Money on my dresser. We got a decon, geeked up like a professor. I put money on my enemy.
Sick it up.
Yep.
The Wild Wild West.
What's up, everybody? He is the Crab Man. Give it up for KC Rocket.
Cocaine all night long. When I die, bury me with all my ice on.
Real trap shit.
We were meant to love.
You guys don't understand me, dude. I'm just gonna fucking Blair Witch the rest of this set. Who gives a shit? I come from old money. This doesn't matter to me. A lot of setup for not a big laugh, don't you think? Come on now. Think you're better than me. Cody, they don't like it. Fuck, he's gone. Shit.
Yep, super wild, fucking Austin, Texas. Nimesh Patel!
Hi. One more time for everyone you've seen.
Gangsta Grills, the Grills.
Money, get a dollar and a dick. Weezy baby, that crack, motherfucker, get a fix. Got money out the ass, no homo, but I'm rich. About the
Gangsta Grills,
money, get a dollar and a dick. Weezy baby, that crack, motherfucker, get a fix. Got money out the ass, no homo, but I'm rich. About to go get surgery and put some diamonds in my wrist. Yes, yep. I'm a motherfucking trip. I'm a trip to Japan to buy some brand new shit. 900 to the grand, get you 28
grams. If you talk about bitch, I'm the interstate man. And the women say, damn, the niggas don't say a damn thing. Boy, I bet that shot it make you bounce like a bed spring. Walk in a thin line, gotta defend my.
I heard some cheers for truck driver, got some DUIs in the crowd. You guys are so fucking stupid. And some real text shit. I want the freedom to drive drunk. Who, how many DUIs? Huh? How many you got, buddy? How many you racked up?
My dad has three.
Your dad, it's not hereditary, you fucking idiot. Yeah, it sort of runs in the family. Well, what are you gonna do? I inherited three DUIs.
I don't know how it happened. Like the other week, there was an article. Victoria's Secret got a model with Down syndrome, and I focused on the word "got." That I thought that was the operative word in that headline. I was like, "What do you mean? Like they trapped her?" That poor girl, they got her. We got to save this young woman from Victoria's Secret, who my whole life I've been led to understand is a company that exploits women and makes them feel bad about themselves. But no, they got a woman with Down syndrome, and so I react, and I'm like, that's fucked up. People are like, you're an asshole. And I'm like, I'm an asshole? I don't understand how this even fucking happened. I'm at the fucking, like, brass balls you have to as a marketing guy at Victoria's Secret to cruise into the office Monday morning being like, okay, check this out.
Look at you, little BTS boy.
Woo. Where the hell's that red light coming?
Spicy chicken sandwich, the greatest chicken sandwich of all time. You can have better ones that are more expensive or worse ones that are cheaper, but oh yeah, dog. Sponsor me, Wendy's.
Hey folks, here we are in the Paramount Theater on 6th Street in Austin, Tejas, for the Moon Tower Comedy Festival. Second time playing. First time was during COVID. It was half full. I bragged and said it was sold out, but it was half full capacity. Now it's actually sold out to capacity. Onward and upward. Comedy! There you go. One take, Jake.
There we go.
A dude was pushing himself across the street in a wheelchair with a bag of, like, piss or shit hanging off the side. And then I got to the other side of the street and there was a woman just crying into traffic. Like, just like,
wow. Like,
what is this place?
Yeah, it's like GTA out there. Part of me thinks they're just waiting to talk. They don't even want to hear the act.
Hi, sorry.
How are we?
Oh, oh shit. Oh, yeah.
How was the Netflix? Was it worth it?
I think it was, yeah. I think it helped the YouTube, and then the YouTube helped that. It was like a weird...
Oh, great.
The YouTube special. And it's a new audience, and then dumb people, I think, they see it's on Netflix, and they think you're better.
Correct.
Yes, correct, yes.
Blind guy, and I'm watching with a seeing eye dog, and I thought, you know what? Who picks up his shit? More open-minded than us. Talk about representation. Austin, you're the best. Thanks for coming out. They were like hungry for it. I did that ashy joke and they were like, here's my act. Can you get any footage with this low light?
It's gotta be something. It's a low light setting, I'm sure.
Alright.
Maybe.
Oh, you gotta get a shot of that if you can.
Yeah, a little more.
Hold on.
I'll drive slow.
Yeah. Thank you.
We just get rearing.
Yeah.
No, we're good.
That'd be a good video.
That'd be the greatest footage.
Tell me when we're good to go.
We got it.
Let it know, Dave.
We got it.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's a shot.
See that screen? It's sold out.
It's gotta feel fucking nice. I think the festival helps you. It gives you a boost.
Oh, stop it!
Right.
You're not selling out. You fucking jerk off. What an asshole! This kid's killing it. He's like, I think the moon.
No, you already know. It's all you
know. No, you're right.
You know.
You're right.
Thank you.
You're nobody. You're right.
Thank you. Fun to go from a theater, have a hot set, then you go to this rock club and eat your ass. That's comedy for you, folks. We'll see how this next show goes. It's singing, karaoke, goddamn comedy jam. That's how I think of it. The goddamn comedy jam. I gotta go do this. We'll see what happens. It's a style change. I'm not a singer, I'm not a dancer, I'm not a performer, but
we don't
check with it scares me, so that's why I'm doing it. It's gonna be ugly. Alright, let's get it over with. What a nightmare.
So excited that this next dude's here. Yeah, I think he's one of the funniest dudes I know. I love him to death. We're gonna fucking give him a huge round of applause and be very supportive for the one, the only, Mark Norman!
Nervous, I'm gay. We'll see what happens. Gonna try a song I love. I grew up with this song, it means a lot to me. I don't know all the words, but I think you guys might. So, let's get it going there.
Make sure you're nice with Mark Norman. Come on, guys.
I tried to get out of this many times.
This is how we do it.
Guys, make some noise for Mark Norman, everybody.
I can't believe I got him to do that. You understand? You should be fucking.
That goddamn comedy jam was tough. I feel like there have been some bad ones, but that one was like exceptionally bad. And, I tried to tell him. I tried to get out of it. He talked me into it. But part of me was like, that was horrible, but I'm glad that you saw how horrible it was, because I told him it would be bad. But he was very nice about it. I'm happy it's over.
He's gonna be mad at me.
No, I'm not mad at you. I feel
you
like.
You set me up for a win, man. You set me up for a win, bro. I appreciate it.
Good shit. Send me photos of you guys making out.